In this video presentation, we're working with 50 by 50 galvanized steel trunking. This is our trunking exercise, or a slightly different version depending on whether we're at level one or level two. And we're required at one stage to insert the fixings, in this case, they're already in these two pieces, our turnbuckle clips, in order to secure the lid to the actual trunking itself. The lid comes with the trunking. Trunking's a standard 3 meter length, and it has already the manufacturer's fastenings on the lid. However, for my students, I require them to cut those off and insert our own fixings for the lid. I've chosen turnbuckle clips. We're gonna look at these in this presentation. So we're gonna use a little turnbuckle clip in order to secure our lid onto our trunking. First of all, we're always gonna work with the lower piece above the consumer unit, even if it's at level one or level two, the same piece of lid will be worked with first. First of all, you're required to make sure it's the correct length. No point going about putting the turnbuckle clips in and then discovering it's a little bit too short. We're going to have to start again. So confirm with me that the lid is the correct length. Deburr it both ends before we move on to put the turnbuckle clips in to secure it. And we're going to look at that in the next part of the presentation. So I brought the trunking lid over to the bench, and I'm going to want to come in about 50 mil from each end and mark the center of the trunking lid before we go about drilling it. We can make those marks using a scriber. Drawback using a scriber is obviously we damage the zinc galvanizing the lid and it can be prone to corrosion, especially if we put a mark in the wrong place. And for the ease of the presentation, I'm just gonna use a permanent pen. So I'm gonna come in approximately 50 mil from each end. First of all, approximately there. Turn it around, and again, 50 mil in from the other end. So I've come in 50 mil approximately, but now I've actually got to find the center. This is more of a crucial mark perhaps than the 50 mil, and we've got to find exactly the center of that line there. Just set my combination square up. I'm going to position it on the side and hopefully find exactly the center. And same on the other end. So I've got a little cross now. So hopefully I've found exactly the center of these. We can use a dot punch next before we go in and drill what will effectively be three holes to make it bigger and then bigger and then bigger again in order that we can insert our turnbuckle clip. So let's do the dot punch in the next part of the presentation. So I've positioned a block of wood into the vise in order to make it a little bit easier for me to do the dot punching rather than doing it on the bench. We can see we've got our two marks. We're very careful to get it in the center of the cross. Lay onto the block of the wood. I take my dot punch, I find exactly the center. And this is the bit you need to just take your time with. And it's just one dink in order to make a mark of which will be the position for the first hole to be drilled. And then likewise, turn it around. Take your time to find the center of the cross, and again just one dink in order to mark it. We're not trying to make a hole with the dot punch, we're trying to give us a mark to start a hole. So I've got my two positions here and I'm now ready to start drilling, which effectively will be probably a 3 mil followed by a 6 followed by a 10 in order to fit these turnbuckle clips into the front of the lid. Let's see that in the next part of the presentation. So ready now to drill the first hole, which is probably a 3 mil high speed steel drill bit that we're going to put through. We've got the dot punches in place. I've taken the block of wood back out of the vise. I'm not going to just put the lid in the vise itself. We can bend it. This is quite flimsy trunking lid. So to increase the jaws of the vise and give us something to drill into, so I'm not bothered if our drill goes through obviously the metal front lid and into the wood at the back. I'm going to position the block of wood behind like so, making sure the area that I'm drilling, which will be about here, goes through and into the wood itself. So position it in like so, and now we're ready to drill through from the dot punch through the front lid into the wood at the back in the next stage of the presentation. As I'm now about to drill my first hole, I'm going to put on my safety goggles and I'm going to drill that first hole using my 3 mil. So we've got a 3 mil high speed steel drill bit inside my DeWalt drill. I've also got it set up with a 6 and a 10 ready for the next part of the presentation as well. So let's go through with the 3 first. So I've gone through my dot and I've gone into the block of wood. Can now move it to my 6 mil high speed steel drill bit next. And again through and into the block of wood. And then the final one is a 10 mil high speed steel drill bit. Got to do the same on the other side, and then I've obviously got to deburr it before we put the turnbuckle clips in.
So let's flip it over and do the same on the other side. Block of wood round, position it so it's the dot and the block of wood round the back. Into our vise, firm but not overly tight, because obviously you don't want to dent the lid itself. 3mm first, which that one isn't. 3mm first, which that one is. Three. Six, and the one that's more tricky, it tends to grip a little bit with this one, just be careful on the 10, so on the 10. And both ends are now done. We've got 3, 6, 10 on both ends. We now need to deburr it, and I'll show you how to put the turnbuckle clips in after that. So I've deburred my lid around the two 10mm holes. I've separated out my turnbuckle clip into its three parts. So I've separated the front bit, which is rotated with a flat-headed screwdriver, the washer, and the bar at the back, which will secure the lid and the trunking together. So I've separated those out, and it's a case of, on the front side, the washer, followed by the part which is rotated, and you have to press reasonably firm now in order that you can put the bar through the back. So if I rotate that into the correct position, push it firmly forward, and then we push the bar in, which can be really tricky to push it into its position. There we go, so I pushed it down into its position, and we can see now when it's rotated, it will fasten to the trunking and hold the lid into position. So we do that on both ends. See what I mean about removing them? They can be really quite tight in order to pull them apart. The washer is in place. Position the washer on the outside, followed by the head. Push firmly in, so I'm pushing nice and firmly in. Push my centre bar now into position until it feels like a mini click. And then we're like so. So our turnbuckle clips are in place. We can now take it over to the exercise to see if it fits correctly.
So the final stage is just to fit the lid. We must use a really large flat-headed screwdriver. These are only quite soft plastic. If you use just the electrician screwdriver or medium flat tip, whichever you want to call it, you can damage the plastic around these ends. So large flat tip screwdriver, the largest we've got in our workshop. Lid's held into position like so. Push firmly against it and rotate. Firmly against it and rotate, and you can see now how the lid is secured against the trunking at the back, no gaps either end, and that's the lid fitted with the turnbuckle clips. I hope this video has been some help.